in the first video, what we are going to do is tackle the first problem, which is identifying what is a good trade. So the markets have just opened, it's July 24th. And what we are seeing here, you'll see two columns here. One is for day trades and one is for swing trades. The day trades column, obviously, it looks at very, very short time frames. So you can see that we have a 1 day, 1 minute chart. Let's just analyze this day trades column and then we'll look at the swing trades column. So once the markets open, the day trades column becomes very active and you can see that stocks are changing states. That's because in the day trading algorithm, the changes happen very quickly. So let's first take a look at Apple. Here we see that Apple is bullish. And of course, the gray area is the pre-market. And sure enough, as soon as the markets opened, you can see that Apple has gone up significantly just about in the last 10 minutes or so. You can see that if you wanted to take a trade, you could take a trade once you saw right from the pre-market that Apple was going to be bullish. And of course, the S&P is also up today. So that works for all stocks. All stocks are correlated to the S&P 500 index in some sort, in some manner or the other. So Apple is a good example of a good day trade. Let's look at Starbucks. That's another one here. Starbucks, not so much. Regardless, it is still bullish. And so the signal has come up. Now let's look at Goldman Sachs. Now this is also much better. This is like Apple. So you can see in the pre-market, there was not a whole lot of action in Goldman Sachs. But once the markets have opened, Goldman Sachs is moving up about $2 or $3 here. So that is how you would look at the day trades column. In general, I would not advise you to take a trade right at the market open because that's always going to be a little volatile. However, once the markets settle in and you get a certain idea of how the markets are going, then you want to get into these kind of trades. Now, if you're day trading, you probably won't be in the trade for more than maybe 15 minutes, 20 minutes, half an hour, maybe even 1 hour. If the trend continues, you can stay in the trade. And you'll see that this custom RSI helps you stay in the trade. And we'll get to that in a separate video. But in this video, this day trades column, you can see will identify what are the good stocks to day trade for today. In the following videos, we'll cover the swing trading column as well. And then we'll go into the detail into all of these indicators, the multi-time frame trend indicator, the custom RSI, as well as there is something called the SPX ticks, which measures the breadth of the market. And so we'll get into all of those in individual videos. This video was just to cover how you can identify what are the good trades. And if it's a bearish day, then you would want to look for the very bearish candidates. But today, given that the S&P is up about 10 or 12 points already at the open, you're going to want to look for bullish trades. And that's exactly what this column does. Thanks.